Welcome to May. This is your general reading that will cover the general theme, the beginning, middle, and end of the month, the best part of the month, the biggest challenge, and then guidance and give you your crystal of the month that'll help you get through it as unscathed and as easy as possible, okay? It'll help you with all the things that you need. So, this is for your sun sign. Career videos are gonna look like this and they'll come out soon. So make sure you're subscribed and you hit the notification bell so you know when they come out. They are for your rising sign. This video right here will tell you why that is if you're not sure. And then love videos come out halfway through the month and this is what they're gonna look like, okay? So let's get started. If you're interested in what decks I'm using for this reading, I've got the Cosmic Tribe Tarot. Looks like this. And then the Angel Prayers Oracle by Kyle Gray. If you purchase them through the affiliate links down below, I might get a couple cents, which would be helpful in me continuing to make these videos because YouTube pays you like, I don't know, $20 a year. but it doesn't cost you anything extra. So I would appreciate that if you're interested in buying a deck. And so, Aries, your general theme for the month of May is that, you know, it's kind of a bummer month. A lot of you can't go out and party and celebrate. And even if you live in a state where you could or in a place where you can, guess what? People are scared, right? Sucks. I get it. So what does the beginning of the month look like for you? The middle and then the end. So there's a lot going on in the beginning of May for you. So number one, first thing is that you're a little bit defensive, you know. Maybe you had an expectation and then it didn't go as planned. And so then, you know, people are questioning like, hey, what's going on with you? What's happening? And then you're trying to be, you know, self-preserve. You're a little bit shut off, closed off, putting walls up this month. But you'll get your confidence back. I think, you know, you're going to start shining your Aries fire sign self a little bit more as the month progresses. This is a piece of you that never goes away. You know, it's a consistent part of you. So don't beat yourself up, you know, that you're feeling down in the beginning of the month. Basically, right now, you're supposed to be doing less. Don't work so hard. Don't wear yourself out. Figure out, I feel like Leo's had something similar where it was about self-care. Maybe that's something that you need to focus on more a little bit right now. So they're saying you'll be back to your old self in no time. And so, you know, you can't control a lot of situations and circumstances that are going on around you right now. And that's hard to cope with and deal with. But just kind of accept it, do a little less, and you'll be back to feeling yourself in no time. It won't be such a bummer energy that follows you throughout the month of May then. What they're saying here is there's nothing to be afraid of, okay? There's no reason to be concerned or to be afraid this month. They're saying, you know, even in regards to money and job, maybe some of you are looking for something, maybe some of you are really struggling, and they're saying like, you're not gonna come up with some magical new idea that changes your life entirely, you know, by the end of the month. And this might seem unlucky, but like, calm down, because the fact of the matter is you can't control the situation. It is what it is. So just take a deep breath. Remember who you are and what you have to offer the world, because it is much, okay? So the best part of the month for you is going to be the things that don't really change, because at least consistency is there. Like, you know what, I mean, okay, so things are going to change for you for the better eventually, but like at least right now you know what to expect, even if you're not really loving it. Here's the thing. Some of you are not going to experience positive change this month because there is something that you're addicted to, whether it's a mindset, a belief system, maybe it's an actual substance, and it's holding you back. It's preventing you from moving forward. Now, for those of you that don't have those issues, they're like, come on, let's be real. Everybody has that issue in one way or another, okay? Let's be honest, let's be open, let's be real with yourself. If you don't know what they are, I can give you a tarot reading and tell you what they are, a personal reading. But everybody's got something that prevents them from moving forward, a little sticking point in their subconscious somewhere. They're saying this is the big problem for the majority of you. And for those of you where that sadness kind of lasts a little longer, where they have more struggle this month than others, it's because there's something that you're not letting go of, whether that's a relationship from the past, whether it's a mindset that doesn't serve you. Whatever it is, we've got to identify that, number one. And then once we identify it, move through it to get past it. And I mentioned in, I think, with the Leo video, a lot of people don't know this because it's on invite-only basis for my long program, but I'm a life coach for purpose and happiness. And I think I'm going to do, just for the month of May, a couple introductory two-hour sessions. So if you're interested in that, link is going to be below in the description box, probably just for the month of May because it's a lot. But biggest challenge for you moving forward is, you know, understanding and accepting that things are the way they are. And also for a lot of you, committing to a plan, to like a day-to-day schedule, staying consistent if you're not working. And like I said, just to work less. A lot of you are doing a lot. And maybe it's to avoid whatever it is that you need to work through. But for whatever reason, because you're actually working a lot because you work in a hospital, or maybe it's because you're taking advantage of this time to get your house remodeled, or, you know, whatever. It doesn't matter the circumstance and the situation. You've got to do a little less, and that's really challenging. So the guidance for you this month are a couple things. Number one, move your body around, because when you move your body, when you move your physiology, you move your psychology around. You know, your psychology follows your physiology. So if you're just to stand up and dance to a song you really love, your mood elevates a lot, which will help you a lot in the beginning of the month when you kind of have that bummer energy going on. And then the other thing is, I would try to use some sort of energy healing techniques. Imagine a bright light coming through your body and just picking up any stagnant energy that doesn't have to be there, anything that doesn't serve you. And a lot of you should maybe watch this video right here that is about cords of attachment and how to release things if you know what it is or who it is that you need to release and detach from. That would help you, I think, significantly. Then also the miracle of forgiveness is very important. So not only forgiving other people, but forgiving yourself, you know, for different things in your past that maybe are bumming you out right now. Maybe you weren't really good at savings and now you wish you would have been. Okay, well, I forgive myself for not saving. I guess I'm thankful for the lesson now, and you move on. Or, you know, whatever the situation is, maybe there's somebody in your life you need to forgive. But those are kind of the things that are going to help you have a better second half of the month. Because for some of you, it's going to be a minimal struggle. It's going to be just kind of like a slight, you know, case of the blahs. But for others of you, this could be a pretty icky depression kind of vibe in the beginning. And I think that's the best way to heal it. So your crystal of the month is Tiger Eye. I'm happy to tell you all about the reasons why and how it benefits you. But I'm not going to waste time in a video doing that because not everybody gives a shit. So if you give a shit, in the description box below, there is a link to my website in which you can look that up on my blog page. I love you so much.